Hi, this is Kimmy B here with Pretzels in History. And believe it or not, we were here at Lititz Springs Park. Corey told us that there was going to be a WWE wrestler at the park. And coincidentally, we ran into him.
Yes, you actually did. But since we're here, we're going to make this a little special, right? So let's give it a little bit of pizzazz. I mean, it's 4th of July weekend. We got to give it a bit. Damas y caballeros, yo soy Ricardo Rodriguez. I'm super excited to be here. I really am.
Okay, so Mr. Rodriguez, can you please tell us, how did you get started into wrestling?
So I used to wrestle when I was in high school, and then from there, eventually I jumped into a bunch of different things. I did the whole backyard wrestling, and then eventually when I was about 19 years old, I went out and I got trained properly. And I was on the independent scene for roughly about 4 years in Los Angeles, all over the States, in Europe, Mexico. And then eventually I got a trial with WWE, and it was supposed to be a one-time thing, and it turned into a five-year journey. Those 5 years eventually came to an end, but the wrestling kept going. I was able to travel to many, many different countries throughout the globe, be it throughout, like I said, throughout the US, throughout Mexico, throughout Europe. I lived in India, I lived in Egypt. I just got back from Egypt after a year, Australia. So I'm very happy that road brought me eventually to here, where we are now in Lititz. Which, by the way, let me sidetrack a little bit. I know you can tell I'm not from here, because when I say Lancaster, they kind of, you know, bark at me a little bit. It was Lancaster. And then I need to know what's the proper way to say Lititz. Is it Lititz?
Yes, Lititz. All right, Lititz.
All right, well, there we go then. I'm a native now. But I'm super excited to be here. 4th of July weekend. We're going to be celebrating with big fireworks and big kabooms. And at 8:30 later on, I'm not sure when this is coming out, but later on this evening, we're going to be on stage holding a little, you know, music, celebration, dancing, all that other stuff. And we're going to be auctioning off giving away tickets for the a pro wrestling event that we have in Lancaster, Barnstormer Clipper Magazine Stadium on August 20th. And for you guys that are listening, you can go online at lancasterbarnstormers.com /pro-wrestling to pick up your tickets.
Could you tell us what it's like to be in WWE, and how did you get there?
It's very surreal. It really is. Just because I watched it when I was younger. I watched it, you know, as I was in high school and then coming out of high school, and to be able to go and perform in front of thousands of people, and then not only that, but performing in multiple WrestleManias, and then to be broadcasted, honestly, internationally. It was definitely a dream come true. And if it wasn't for WWE, there's a lot of things I never would have accomplished. Just the social media reach that we have because of WWE is amazing. It's very incredible how we can contact folks just through social media, like how this happened.
Okay.
So it was a blessing. It really was. It really was a blessing.
I bet, because I always dreamt of being a big star and celebrity. It, like, seriously, that has been my dream, and we're somewhat making that happen now with this YouTube channel called Pretzels in History. So, like, I saw that you were WWE wrestler at one point, your former one, and then you became WWE manager. So what's it like being a wrestler and then going to manager?
It was hard at first because I came into this industry as a wrestler. And then when I was told that I was going to be a personal ring announcer / manager, it was kind of heartbreaking at first because my dream was to be a wrestler. Mm. But the way I saw it at the time was I was given an opportunity to be a WWE superstar, which I was very grateful for that opportunity and for what it transpired eventually becoming a wrestler within WWE. I know, and listen, I mean, I am a firm believer that if you put your hard work into it and you really want something, so long as you really put the effort, you'll achieve what you want to accomplish. I really am a firm believer in that. So I think you're going to be a superstar, and we're going to make sure she's a superstar.
And also our producer as well.
Everybody, the whole thing,
exactly.
the whole team.
Exactly.
So I'm happy to be here, though.
Oh, good. And then how many pounds, like, can you lift?
Oh, man. Not as much as I can eat. So I don't know. I can't remember the last time that I fully weighed what I can max out on. But I don't know. I mean, let's just say 1,000 pounds. Let's just say a bajillion pounds. I can lift the earth.
And then what's it like to work with other like celebrities like John Cena and all that? Because I saw you your one match where they were saying John Cena. Yeah. You're like, and then it wasn't that he was there, but then you worked with Undertaker. So what's it like meeting those guys? And do you all get along?
It was a dream come true, honestly. I mean, and it was such a big learning experience, especially for me coming into WWE as a wrestling fan. And obviously, you know, being in high school and then getting out of high school and watching those individuals on TV, it was amazing. And to start off my WWE career with, you know, Rey Mysterio, Edge, Kane, eventually John Cena, CM Punk, so many Undertaker, eventually meeting, you know, guys like Stone Cold, Brock Lesnar, and getting the chance, The Rock, getting a chance to work with those guys, it was a dream come true. It really was.
Now, yeah, like sometimes you fight, like, but are you guys like family, or does it come to be where it's not family since you have to see each other every day?
You know how like you have your brother or sister that you just, yeah, they're family, but like you just want to give them one of these little ones every now and then. I think of something like that. Yeah, we're all like in the same business and we're all working together per se, but you don't have to like them.
Gotcha.
No, we don't sometimes. It happens.
So, like, when you all retire, like, do you still keep in touch with each other, or do you just lose contact completely?
I think it's like anything else. The people that you want, or the people that are going to be in your life, will be in your life. Same thing as, you know, when you get out of high school and everybody writes on your yearbook, stay in touch, yeah, and they put their phone number, and then you never hear from them. Every now and then you'll get a little, like, Facebook reminder, like, people you may know, but the people you want in your life, they will stay in your life. And I still am very fortunate that I have several that I still talk to.
Oh, that's awesome. I'm glad.
Yeah, me too.
That's
me too.
Awesome. That is a blessing. Because I always say, always keep in touch with close ones that you
definitely,
you know, came in touch with. I believe in that.
Definitely.
And then what is it like, say, like, if you guys get, like, sick, like, cold-wise or food poisoning, like, severe, do you still have to go out in the ring? Or how does that work?
Oh, yeah, the thing that makes, which is what I believe, that makes us superstars that we were called. It's not the wrestling. It's all the stuff that we have to do outside of the wrestling aspect of it. The constant travel, the meeting people, the being working while you're sick, being away from your family six, 7 days out of the week. I remember the last time, the longest that I was away from home on just a single loop of wrestling was like 27, 28 days straight before I went back home. That's what I believe makes us superstars. So if we're sick, we're sick. But yeah, we're still going to go. You know, get your medicine, get your DayQuil, and then let's rock and roll. Get your sanitizer, and we're still rocking and rolling.
So it's like, so, no matter if you have a stomach bug or something, you're still going.
Wow. We might alter things here and there. We might switch things up a little bit, but we're still working.
Wow, that's crazy. And then, what did you ever get hurt, like seriously hurt? Because I know some of those guys, with the chairs, the necks, like sometimes they don't come out alive. Mm. Like you hear like horrible stories about death, so.
It's an unfortunate aspect of our business, and just like anything else, I mean, in any sport, there are concussions, broken fingers, broken hands, concussions, dislocated jaw, broken ribs, messed up knees, ankles. It's all part of it. It's all part of it. And it's unfortunate some people don't have a long longevity in ring, but what we try to do is we try to work around whatever injuries that we have, or once we quote unquote retire, we find a way to stay in the business doing something else but still being inside of it. But it's an unfortunate aspect of any sport. Injuries will happen in any sport, more so in a contact sport like wrestling, boxing, football, stuff like that. You're more than likely to get hurt.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that is true. Did you have any concussions or anything?
I've had several concussions.
Oh,
I've had several concussions.
Oh, my.
They're not fun. They're not fun, so don't get concussed.
Oh, I can't imagine what that's like for you. Because, you know, when they say after you have too many concussions, what happens when a doctor tells you guys, hey, you might not be able to do this anymore because if you do it, it's going to kill you. Like, how does that affect you guys? Or is it just that I'll just keep going?
No, I think now we're a lot smarter about it because even though there's still no way of checking your brain and all that stuff until you actually pass, which is unfortunate, but there is a lot more knowledge as far as the CTEs and the damage that's caused, as it has been seen in football, in boxing. After the unfortunate passing or the incident that happened with Chris Benoit back in the mid-2000s, there was a lot of wake-up occasions for a lot of sports entities. So it's unfortunate, but yeah, no, and it sucks when somebody tells you, hey, you can't do this anymore. It's something that you're passionate, that you spent so many years. I've been doing this for 16 years this month, 16 years. So for somebody to come in and say, hey, you can't do it anymore, it's going to be hard. I hope that day never happens. But like I said, that's the advantage of being able to jump into something else, but still be within the world of wrestling. So that's ultimately what I want to do once my body says no more.
So when your body says no more, what's your next plan? Are you going to be like an actor like The Rock and Cena?
Those are really big shoes to fill. But in the meantime, what we're doing is we're just promoting the show. So I'm just promoting.
Awesome.
Promoting. I'm doing ring announcing. I'm doing commentary. I'm doing a whole bunch of other stuff. So as I get older, obviously my body won't be able to stay in the ring as much as I would like to. So we find alternatives. And in my case, promoting.
Awesome. Now, is it true like... You know, some wrestlers, they go way big. Like, it's like, oh, I can buy any car. They go out, you know, they have, you know, 20 different motorcycles, 20 cars, a big fancy mansion. And, you know, just like how they showed it on Rocky, where he got all these fancy things, and then he lost it all.
He lost it.
And then he couldn't get it back. Are you guys in that position as well? Like, is it true, or is that all false?
It's very true. It does happen a lot. It's an unfortunate thing. And that's not just in wrestling, that's any sport, you know, especially when you're young, you get all this money, you go crazy on it, you buy all these cars, you buy your houses, your jewelry, all the expensive clothes and, you know, the parties. I've experienced that side of it too, but I think for the most part, I was more reserved on my side. First paid off my school loan. So F you, Sally Mae. I paid off my school loan, all my debts, my car, I paid it all off. So that was my main focus, but... No, it does happen. It does happen. But now, like I said, now that we're older, we get wiser.
Right.
So we save up a whole lot more.
And then what about retirement and health care? Because you guys don't get benefits, though, for this, do you?
Not on the independent circuit. When you're with WWE, yes, you get taken care of. So if you with WWE, they'll take care of you. If you get hurt in ring, they'll take care of you.
What about retirement, though?
Well, we get paid pretty well. So like, we can always, but it also depends on the individual.
Okay.
How much he saves or if he saves. So there's so many different factors, and everybody's different.
I like your respect. People need to learn from you because that's how I learned from my mom. Watch what you spend because it's going to get up to you. And I like that, how you think like me where, you know, what comes first and not, you know, the expensive house and the jewelry. Like the bills come first.
Yeah, bills come first.
I mean, that.
Especially with school loan. That was
exactly. I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
But yeah.
And did you ever have to, well, no, you graduated and then you got into this, so you didn't have to drop out then, right?
No.
That's good.
I did my high school, I did my I got my degree, I did all that stuff. I was working on an independent level while I was getting my degree in graphic design and animation. And then I became pro when I was 24.
Nice. So. Now, are you the youngest wrestler or are you the oldest wrestler that started their career at the WWE?
Oh, no, neither one of those. Neither one of those. Like, I'm above average of what we usually start with WWE. Early 20s. So I started WWE at 24.
Oh.
So that's about early 20 to mid 25. That's usually what time the average of when people start around there.
Okay.
But, I mean, I started wrestling when I was 20.
Okay.
So yeah, that's about it.
And then, like, what are the ages then? Like, where they say to you, you know, you got to retire. Like,
Different. Everybody's different. It depends on if you take care of your body, how much damage you put into it, how smart you are about everything. There's so many different factors. So there's not one way to tell one story. There's so many different avenues that you can take. It's kind of like one of those books that when we were younger, if you want this to happen, turn to page 30. If you want this to happen, go to page 15. And you just kind of go from there. So it's so many different ways.
Awesome. Layton, do you have any questions?
Well, let's see here. What are your goals? I mean, as far as like moving forward at this point, do you plan on working more as like a coach at all? You ever try coaching?
That's what I was doing in India. That's what I did in Egypt. That's what I did all these other countries. I was opening up wrestling schools. So I hope to eventually one day open up something here in Lancaster. And then open up my own academy. But like I said, right now, my main focus is just this event. That's where we're going. And then eventually run more events to bring pro wrestling back to Central Pennsylvania.
So how many events has there been recently?
Here, none.
Wow.
So this will be one of the first ones in, at least on big shows. This will be one of the bigger shows I think they said 2018. So pre-COVID. So we're just trying to get that back in the area. There's been smaller events here and there. But I know there's a market for it here. I know there is.
Sure there is. Yeah.
I was going to say Giant Center over in Hershey held WWE Raw. Where this one's going to be?
No, this is in Lancaster. Pennsylvania is a whole different direction.
Oh, wow. So, yeah. So, in Lancaster, where at then, may I ask?
It's going to be at the Clipper Magazine Stadium by downtown Pennsylvania. Oh, downtown Lancaster, excuse me.
As far as I know, because I could tell you right now, I lived in this area for my whole life. Mm-hmm. And like I said, you and I are a year apart. You're younger than me. Sorry to turn out your age, but we're not going to say that because we're still young looking and we're still good looking. I think, and so is the producer over there. But, it's funny because now that you said that, I don't think Lancaster did at the Clipper Stadium ever a Raw wrestling thing. No. So you will be the first.
Yep, so we're
going
big.
We will try to
make
that.
No, definitely. So if, like I said, if you guys are watching this or listening to this, LancasterBarnstormers.com/pro-wrestling.
Awesome. And that's August when?
August 20th. RVD, WWE Hall of Famer, RVD, Alberto El Rio, Santino Marella, Fandango, and of course, yours truly, Ricardo Rodriguez.
Awesome.
All right. Sounds great.
Hey, that's good.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah,
it'll
be fun.
Nothing right now.
Okay.
No, you just catch me anytime.
Well, thank you, Mr. Rodriguez.
Of course.
It was a pleasure to meet you. On to www.pretzelsandhistory.com to buy our t-shirts and our hoodies.
Right. Pretzelsandhistories.com. Okay.
Yeah.
Damas y caballeros, check out www.pretzelsandhistories.com and pick up all your best, awesome pretzel and history merchandise.
With hoodies and t-shirts.
Woo!
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Love it. You're
right.
So is that the joke then, or is there...
Ask him.
Is there a punchline though?
Yeah, I don't know. Ask him if he's ever put anybody in a pretzel before.
Oh, right.
Oh, yeah, yes.
Are you ready? Are we filming? Or do I need a mic? Or am I good?
Just do it now, because the mic is for the other camera.
Okay. But you can hear us.
Yeah, we can hear
you. Okay. Did you ever put anybody in a pretzel before?
Yes, I did. My little sister, my cousins, my girlfriend one time, and she wasn't too appreciative of it. And then eventually you get put on this thing called a doghouse. I don't know, but I'm not allowed to do it anymore. But yes.
What was that like?
Not fun. Oh, the putting the pretzel thing? Yeah, that was fun. Not the aftermath. That was.
So how do you put them in a pretzel?
Oh, I can't. I wouldn't want to.
Okay.
Turn around, Kim. Hey, Kim, turn around real quick. Just kidding.
Are there pretzels in Mexico?
So we don't have pretzels per se, but we do have pretzels. But what we would have is the equivalent would be called a churro. So it's kind of, I'm sure you've heard of it before, it's kind of like a pretzel, but it's covered in cinnamon, and it's a lot softer.
Sounds good.
Churro.
We'll have to try some of those.
The tongue roll. I can't do it.
I can't do it either.
Try.
Churro.
Let it flow out of the R. Churro.
You gotta get the tongue roll first.
Practice. I was just saying practice. It takes practice.
Yeah. All right. Okay. All right. Good enough, man. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate you too. And
of course.
We would also like to ask any